Away is all part of the World of Leather winter sale. The special offers from stock, discontinued models at substantial discounts, and interest-free credit on everything over £500. World of Leather, Cheetham Hill Road, Manchester, opposite Comet and Edge Lane, Liverpool. But hurry, sale ends Saturday.
This is my new turkey roast for two. You get up to 10 good slices for only 99 pence. Bernard Matthews, mini turkey leg roast. Beautiful.
Thursday evening on Granada brings a star challenge to sporting triangles.
We're going to have a bash at that there. Newfangled.
Ten lot.
The thing that's more complicated than Lester Piggott's tax returns.
And the comedy continues at 7:30 when Sid makes a new friend.
Well, of course I like him. If you like him, I like him. Come on. Come in, Fred.
A surprise guest in Bless This House. At 8, strike it lucky.
A monster spotting weekend. When do you drink these prizes up?
At 9, an appeal for justice.
Hey, I don't care how short he is, Judge. You can't let him keep pulling this.
I object to this.
This constant manipulation is disgraceful, and you know it.
Counselor.
That's a sizable clash of interests in L.A. Law at 9. And with 9 to 5, T.J. Hooker plus a special session with Ralph McTell, this is Thursday night here on Granada.
Channel 4 has just begun Citizen 2000, looking at 5-year-olds in the classroom. Right, this is the new TV Times cover. Now let's meet the actors from the cover in this series called Singles.
He's off to the carpet again.
Well, why does he want the carpet?
Says it has sentimental value.
The carpet can't have sentimental value.
No, it could for him. He fell down on it often enough. He slept on it a few times, too. Oh, that's not the reason. He says his mother bought it. Actually, she was only good for the underlay. I bought this carpet and I've got an invoice to prove it. That's why I'm keeping watch.
Well, I thought we were going out. Oh, Pam, you can't stay here forever. It's not healthy. You were talking to yourself when I came in.
No, I wasn't.
You're turned funny.
Sooner turned funny than desperate.
Well, what do you mean?
I'm not going to a singles club, Jackie.
Oh, why not?
Because it's full of cranks, weirdos and freaks.
We're not freaks.
We're not going.
It's only £1, Pam. Can't heat a room for that. At least we'd be warm.
You'd be warm if you got chased by a freak.
As a matter of fact, the club attracts a very nice class of person these days. They say there were a couple of estate agents down there last week. What are you smiling at?
You've never forgiven your old man for being a lorry driver, have you, Jackie?
That's not the point. I was always given to believe he owned that lorry. You know that. My trouble was I was too trusting, but not anymore. The next one's going to be different. This time I'm going to find someone more dependable, more mature.
Well, you're going to the right place. Half of them are over 60.
I'd sooner be an old man's darling than a young man's slave, Pamela. I'm not making that mistake again.
Our mistake was getting married in the first place.
If you think that, why'd you still wear your wedding ring?
Because it helps me to get a better cut of meat at the butcher's.
You want people to think you're still married, don't you?
I've got nothing against marriage. It was the hours I couldn't stand. And him. He came back last night, drunk as usual, on another carpet raid. He stood there, wheezing and grunting, trying to pull the carpet up. Slob didn't realise he was standing on it. I thought, what did I ever see in you? Of course, he's been falling apart since he left. I've never seen anyone deteriorate so quickly. Oh, and this is the joke. You'll never believe this.
What?
He's actually got a girlfriend.
Oh, I know. I've seen her.
Oh, what's she like? I've heard she's terrible.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
You wouldn't?
Oh, actually, she's quite attractive.
Attractive? Are you sure? How does he do it? He must chloroform them.
Didn't chloroform you.
Wasn't such a slob then. Really attractive.
Oh, in a hard sort of a way.
Yeah, that would appeal to him. She'll have to be hard. He'll walk all over her. Did they seem close?
They were filling a trolley together in Tesco's.
As close as that. Well, he certainly hasn't wasted much time.
Oh, I understood he knew her before...
Before? Before what? You mean before he left?
Yes.
Why didn't someone tell me? Someone must have known. You knew, didn't you? You knew and you didn't tell me. My best friend.
Oh, Pam. I was waiting for him to tell you. I thought he would.
Secretive slob.
Well, what did he say when he left?
He said there were things he wanted to do. Which was a bit surprising because he never wanted to do anything when I suggested it.
He's taken her to Mallorca.
Mallorca? All I got was the Lake District. He wouldn't fly. He said he was frightened of heights. Couldn't even get him up Scarfell.
Well, he seems to have got over it.
Yes.
Are you coming, Pamela?
Really attractive?
Yes.
I'll get ready.
You coming?
I'm having a drink.
We're wasting time. Is that a double?
What if it is?
It's just that I promised your mother.
What?
That you wouldn't drink too much.
I'm not drinking too much.
You had half a bottle in the taxi.
Look, I'm all right.
You weren't all right last night, though, were you?
Who told you about that?
Your mother.
Interfering old bat.
Don't talk about your mother like that, Clive.
Why not?
Because she's the best friend you'll ever have.
You talk about your mother like that.
We're not talking about my mother, we're talking about your mother. And she's worried about you. She said you were lying in the middle of the road weeping.
I wasn't weeping.
Just lucky the buses had stopped running, that's all I can say. Suppose you'd been run over.
I didn't care.
Bloke who ran you over would, though, wouldn't he? You'd have been on his conscience for the rest of his life.
Look, Malk, what I've had done to me...
Oh, yeah, I know what you've had done to you, Clive. I'm just sick of hearing about it, that's all.
It's all right for you, you've never been married.
Wait a minute. I've had my share of heartache. Remember Stephanie?
Stephanie?
All the money I spent on her, all the plans we made. I didn't fall apart when she joined the Moonies, did I? You've got to put it all behind you, old son. You're free now.
Not yet. I'm not divorced.
Don't worry about that. There's quite a few people here who aren't divorced.
You mean they're separated?
Hmm? They are for tonight.
You mean there are married men here? They ought to be castrated.
Yeah, I know your views on castration, Clive.
In public?
Not tonight, Clive.
It was a married man that did this to me, Mel.
I know, but I wouldn't mention that around here. It'll cast a cloud on the proceedings. And don't mention the kids.
Three kids, Mel?
I said don't mention the kids, Clive.
What sort of woman would do that, leave you to raise three kids on a hospital porter's money?
Yeah, and I wouldn't mention that either. Can't we say you're something a little more professional?
Why?
We've got to put a little seed down, Clive.
There's no future in lying.
I'm not worried about the future. I'm only worried about tonight, eh? What about those two over there?
What are you doing? You look as if you're about to climb into that handbag.
We're being stared at.
Oh, good.
Are you going to undo any more of those buttons?
I'm only trying to attract a little interest, Pamela.
You attract a crowd if you go on like that.
Look who's just come in.
Who?
The assistant manager of Barclays.
He's with someone.
She probably pounced on him on the stairs. These women are desperate. We've got to get out there and flaunt it.
Do you mind if I sit here?
No.
Only I don't like sitting on my own. The safety of numbers.
What?
My name's Di. Same as the princess.
Oh, I'm Jackie. This is Pam.
Do you smoke?
No.
No, well, I don't. But I find it useful if someone asks me to dance and I don't like them. I just light up. Saves unpleasantness. And you're not supposed to refuse. It's against the rules.
I think I'll take one for later.
Well, I've no intention of refusing. I came here to meet people. Do you get many professional people here?
Oh, yeah. He's a professional man. The one in the dark suit.
He looks nice. What does he do?
He's an undertaker.
I like the way he's measuring us up and down.
What about the distinguished-looking man sitting next to him?
We call him the proposer.
Well, why'd you call him that?
He always asks you to marry him.
What, straight away?
No. After about the third dance.
What does he do?
Nothing. He's a pensioner.
Do you come here very often, Di?
Oh, yeah. Ever since I was jilted.
You were jilted?
On me wedding day.
I'm sorry.
Said he had amnesia. Forgotten who I was. I mean, we'd lived together for 5 years. How could he forget who I was? Said he'd forgotten who he was, too. He came around washing dishes in a Soho restaurant. Never washed any dishes for me. Comes here sometimes. Still doesn't remember me.
Who's that man at the bar? The one who keeps staring at us.
I'd keep away from him if I were you.
Why?
We call him the octopus.
Well, what do you say? Should we give him a whirl?
I don't know. The one in purple doesn't look very friendly.
Give over. She's dying to meet me.
How do you know?
Body language.
Are you sure?
Yeah. I read a book on it.
I don't know, Malcolm. A bit out of practice.
It'll come back to you.
Well, it's all right for you. You've been doing this for years, non-stop. Don't you ever get bored?
Bored? Of course I don't get bored. I like the variety and excitement. It keeps me going.
Julia and I had variety and excitement.
Did you, Clive?
Just because you're married doesn't mean to say you can't have variety and excitement.
You're doing it again, Clive. Your eyes are filling up.
I'm sorry, it's just... Excuse me.
Clive.
Come on, guys and girls. Let's have you in here on the dance floor. This could be your moment of destiny. So take a card, roll the dice, spin the wheel. You can't be a winner if you don't play the game.
Good, isn't he?
Yeah.
The BBC are after him.
Are they?
We have him most nights. He's very sensitive. Just the hospitals.
Come on, fellas. We've got some lovely girls in here tonight. If I hadn't taken my vow of chastity, I'd be down there.
He's very small, isn't he?
He's a jockey. He's never been the same since he fell off his horse.
And now, a very special message for the little gal in the bar in the purple dress. From someone who really digs you, baby, and wants you to help him make it through the night.
Help me make it through the night.
Do you want to see a really fast estate agent at work? Do you want to see it again? There you have it. Black Horse Agencies. Accurate valuations and thorough local knowledge from people who are specially trained. Altogether, a much smarter move.
The new Sunsilk conditioner is a rich, light mousse that rinses easily away, leaving your hair in beautiful condition. Sunsilk's new conditioner, it's the secret of life in your hair.
It's the new big prize scratch, scratch, scratch card game from the Manchester Evening News. Play noughts and crosses and win £50,000 worth of prizes. You could win a car, a cruise on Canberra, TVs, videos and £22,000 of cash prizes. Start scratch, scratch, scratching only with the Manchester Evening News 6 nights a week.
It's cut price cleaning at Johnson's. 3 cloth garments cleaned for only £5. That's quality cut price cleaning at Johnson's now.
Mighty White soft grain bread with 30% more fibre than ordinary white. Right tasty. Mighty White soft grains for tough kids.
Ooh, yeah.
Sorry, I've just lit a cigarette.
I can wait.
I don't dance much these days.
You don't have to worry, I've got medals for it. You don't remember me, do you?
No. Should I?
Yes. We used to play on the common together when we were kids.
Did we?
I remember you. Tartan trousers, roll neck sweater, urchin cap, and a little brown pony.
I never had a pony.
I always thought that pony was yours.
What pony? I don't know anything about a pony. I had a dog.
Was it brown?
Well, yes.
That must have been it. You wouldn't remember me. Little ragged boy, too shy to speak.
Little ragged boy?
Too shy to speak.
You certainly changed.
I remember you, Samantha.
Pamela?
But they always called you Sam.
Pam.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure. It's my name.
I prefer Sam.
I'll get it changed.
My friends call me Mel.
What do the others call you?
Yeah, you were always superior. I remember you going out on Sundays in your Morris Minor, sitting in the back with your nose in the air. I thought, one day, when I've made it, I'll come back for her.
And have you made it?
Well, you could say that. I'm quite big in imports these days. What are you doing here, Pam?
I came with a friend.
That's what they all say. They never admit it.
Admit what?
That they're lonely.
I'm not lonely. She's lonely.
Oh, yes.
What are you doing here?
I came with a friend. He's suicidal. Wife's just left him. Hey, wait a minute. I've got an idea. Why don't we introduce my friend to your friend? Make the twosome into a foursome.
What twosome?
You and me.
No, I don't think so. My friend's very choosy. She's looking for someone from the professional classes.
Oh, well, then she needn't look any further. My friend's a medical man.
You mean he's a doctor?
Sort of. Well, what do you say?
See if I can find her. Excuse me.
Well, I don't want to go through that again. I didn't come here to dance with a dwarf. Not in these heels. I kept tripping over him. Then he was excused by the undertaker, and we talked about death. That was until his hearing aid broke down. And then I had a dance with the octopus.
The octopus?
Yeah, I didn't realize who he was until he started blowing in my ear and running his fingers up and down my spine. Felt like a saxophone.
Couldn't have been the octopus.
Why not?
I've just been talking to him.
Are you sure?
Yes. He said we used to play together. He called me Sam.
Pam.
No, Sam.
Sam's a man's name.
No, Sam's short for Samantha.
Your name's Pamela.
Oh, no.
He must have a tile loose. Oh, let's get out of here. What a dump. You've had a lucky escape, Pam. The only thing they come down for is a quick feel.
I know. Couldn't believe it when he said his friend was a doctor. A what? A doctor. His wife's left him and he's suicidal. He wanted us to make up a foursome. That's when I made my excuse and left. Come on, I think the coast's clear.
Oh, wait a minute, Pamela. We can't just walk out, not if someone's suicidal. We should show a little charity.
What?
A doctor.
Yes.
I think this calls for a few light repairs.
Doesn't look as if they're coming.
Don't worry, they'll come. The question is, will they stay?
What do you mean?
Well, let's face it, you're hardly the life and soul of the party at the moment.
I'd like to remind you, Malk, that my wife has just buggered off.
Yeah, well, we don't want to hear about all that. And don't go rabbiting on about how she walked out and left three kids playing around a paraffin heater because they won't be interested. Probably got enough problems of their own.
I don't suppose I can.
They'll come.
What makes you so sure?
Body language.
She never even danced with you.
No, but I talked to her. And I'd like to point out that the human voice is a very potent sexual force. I could see she was intrigued. I've always fancied her.
What about the other one?
You mean yours?
Mine? She's not mine.
She is now. She's got social ambitions, and I said you were a doctor.
Bloody hell, Mel.
Well, you know, sort of a doctor.
You can't say things like that.
Well, actually, I said you were a medical man. She assumed you were a doctor.
You can't pose as a doctor. It's against the law.
Well, only if she's a patient. And, I mean, you're not going to examine her. Well, not professionally.
I don't even look like a doctor.
No. It's a pity you didn't wear your clerical grey with the three buttons. I always thought that was a good bit of cloth. The trouble with serge is it wilts. Your lapels are beginning to bend. Do you always sweat like that?
I can't go through with it, Mel. I keep thinking about Julie.
Yeah, well, she's not thinking about you, is she? I mean, She's having it away.
Mal!
Now, don't start that again, Clive. You'll lose all your body salt. Just come on. Hello?
Oh, hello. I was just looking for somewhere to sit.
There's a seat right here. Oh. This is Clive. Pillock. And I'm Malcolm.
Jackie.
Oh, we'll have a seat, Jackie.
Right.
Where's your friend?
She's just coming. Right. She's a little shy, that's all.
Well, can I get you a drink?
Coke, please.
Well, why don't you two sit down and get to know each other, eh?
I've never been here before.
Neither have I.
Never thought I'd find myself in a place like this. I brought poor Pam. She needs the company.
That's what Malk said. He said I needed the company.
Do you mind if I ask you something, Clive? Have you been crying?
No.
I understand. Pam told me, and I'm sorry. I know what it's like. All I can say is time heals all wounds. Not that I have to tell you that, Doctor.
Pardon?
Was it your work, the long hours on the ward? Didn't she understand the pressures?
I'm not sure that it's...
I may be old-fashioned, Clive, but I think a wife should be dedicated to her husband's career. That's one thing my ex could never accuse me of.
Your ex? Oh, what did he do?
Road haulage. Travelled a great deal. And then there were the parties, you know, entertaining. Trouble was, we were never alone.
Oh, we were, all the time, except for the kids.
There were children?
Three.
No.
When I got home the night she left, they were trying to get a meal. Hot chip pan on the stove.
Poor little mites.
Would you like to see a picture?
I wonder where Pam's got to. I'm worried about her, Clive. She never goes anywhere. I think she's becoming agoraphobic.
What's that?
What? Agoraphobic.
Oh, yes, agoraphobic.
Yeah. You must have come across that quite a few times, Doctor.
Yes, I've operated on several cases.
Operated? On agoraphobia?
It's a new technique. Would you like to dance, Jackie?
Oh, yes.
I won't be very good. I never danced with Julie.
Oh, is it bringing it all back? Only I noticed your eyes are a little moist.
Yes, I suppose it is, really. She was taller than you, slimmer. And incredibly graceful.
Yes, well, some people think I'm quite light on my feet.
And she had this amazing sense of rhythm.
Clive, may I make a suggestion? If you want to forget about Julie, perhaps it would be best if you didn't talk about her.
Hello. Would you like to sit down?
Where's my friend?
Jackie, oh, she's dancing with Clive.
She hasn't wasted much time.
Would you like to dance?
No.
A drink?
No, thanks.
Crisps?
Nope.
Would you like to run naked through the hotel shouting rape?
Don't you ever stop talking.
I don't have to talk. It's not essential to my enjoyment, but it does put us above the animals. As a matter of fact, the human voice is a very potent...
What?
Nothing. And solitaire's the only game in town. And every road that takes him down. While life goes on around him everywhere, he's playing solitaire. And so... I hope you don't mind me singing.
No.
People say I've got a good voice.
Do they?
Yeah. I used to have my own group in the 60s. Perhaps you remember me. Ricky Rampant. Blimey, you smiled. I thought you'd forgotten now. I used to do the coffee bars. I remember you. Grey gabardine jacket, draped lapels, black sweater, knotted pearls.
Everyone wore those.
I didn't. You stopped coming, Sam. What happened to you?
I became a policewoman.
A policewoman?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I suppose even a policewoman has to relax.
I'm not relaxing, I'm on duty. There have been complaints.
Complaints?
Yes. We're on the lookout for someone. You see, there are men who prey on women at events like this.
Oh. Is your friend a policewoman?
Yes. She's the sergeant.
She's not very tall.
She's trained in karate. Oh, excuse me. I have to carry out surveillance.
Yeah.
You gone quiet. What are you doing? Leaving.
Why?
It's all right for you. I've got the octopus.
Oh, Pam, the doctor and I are just getting to know each other.
Then let me take your car.
I can't. He hasn't got a car.
A doctor? And he hasn't got a car? How does he get to emergencies?
Well, I mean, he hasn't got it with him. As a doctor, he knows the danger of drink and driving, Pamela.
All right, I'll walk.
You can't. It's miles. Oh, Pam, have I ever asked you to do anything for me?
Yes, often.
I see. Very well. If my happiness means nothing to you, I'll take you home. I'll just say goodnight to Clive. Are you coming?
No, I'm going down the fire escape. I'll see you at the front.
I'll say you're not well. It's not far from the truth. You could have an operation, you know.
Hello. Hot on the trail again?
Yes.
When are you hoping to make an arrest?
Very soon.
Where are your handcuffs?
In my handbag.
Oh, yes.
We're after a man known as the Octopus. Perhaps you've heard of him.
Yes. He's the bloke in the bar with the red bow tie. Everybody knows that.
Oh.
You're not a policewoman. Your feet aren't big enough. You were just trying to get rid of me, weren't you?
Yes.
Well, you didn't have to go to those lengths. You could have said no. I've got my pride.
I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
That's all right. You didn't hurt my feelings. You're entitled to your opinion. I'd just like to point out that I could have had any girl in that room. Could have been your lucky night. That's all. But don't worry. I know when I'm not wanted.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Well, now we got that out of the way, would you like me to see you home?
Certainly not.
Well, I just hope you're satisfied. You spoiled a beautiful evening.
Stop going on, Jackie.
Going on? Have you any idea how much a doctor earns?
Wait a minute. Have you noticed something?
What?
Doesn't it sound hollow in here? Oh, no. The slub. He's taken the carpet.
And the underlay.
And I thought the evening couldn't get any worse. Oh, 20 years of marriage and I'm reduced to bare boards. Well, there's only one consolation. At least I never have any visitors. What's that?
I invited them back for coffee.
Seven, licensed to kill in Octopussy.
Am I to be your target for tonight?
Not necessarily.
You have a nasty habit of surviving.
BJ, we have company.
No problem, this is a company car.
Roger Moore is James Bond in the television premiere of Octopussy, Saturday, 7:15 on ITV.
Back after the break, never the twain.
I can't stop writing.
Look at Shakespeare. 39 plays, 154 sonnets. What a scribbler.
I spend hours writing checks. I can't stop.
Would it help if I presented my bill now?
I can't resist all those spaces to fill in. The amount in figures, the amount in words, the date.
Have you never heard of Barclays Bank?
I'm not daft.
I'll be the judge of that. Look at this.
A credit card?
It's a Barclays Connect card. Thousands of Barclays customers have one. It's exactly the same as paying by check at Visa outlets. All you have to do is to sign your name. Debits your current account direct.
A Barclays Connect card? I'm cured.
What name shall I put on the bill?
Bonaparte. Napoleon Bonaparte.
Oh. award-winning drama in the winter collection on 4 as old habits die hard at Porterhouse College.
We were the last college to abolish celibacy for the fellows.
It cost us dear on the river.
Master didn't name a successor Sheffy. Now, that's never happened in Porterhouse in 532 years.
You've a wonderful memory, Mr. Scullion.
I fear you're going to have to make a few changes to your little habits.
Lust. Good, decent, honest, old-fashioned lust.
Porterhouse imperiled by pyrotechnics and passion at 10:30 tonight on 4.
That's a marvellous series, worth seeing again. Actually, just started on Channel 4 with Nick Ross, A Week in Politics. Right, less than a week. In fact, I'm about to introduce the return of Never the Twain.
Lasting birds again.